So part of the problem that a lot of you are having is that you don't really understand the distribution aspect. Firstly, there's a difference between artist and songwriter. A lot of you have been using your artist name as the songwriter, but that's not correct in the slightest bit. The reason for that is this. Your artist name, or you, the artist, could have, let's say,
multiple artist names.
So you're an R&B artist, but you also rap. Now, you mightn't do them on the same, under the same artist name. You might have two artist names. One is the rapper, one is R&B. You are now getting a foot in the door, let's say. So whichever one starts gaining attention for you, that's the artist name you are going to end up using. But at this stage, you are uncertain of where you stand. So you are using these two names to introduce yourself to the general public. When you are registering your song, you can't use both of those names, the R&B name or the rap name, to put as a songwriter of the song, because your artist name is an alias. Your legal name is a songwriter. Your legal name is the one that pays taxes, and the legal name is also the one that collects royalties. The artist name does not collect royalties. So let's put it this way. I'm Tie-Dye Kitty. Tie-Dye Kitty does not pay taxes. Tie-Dye Kitty does not collect royalties. Sean does. Sean could have many different songs out there, and Sean will collect the royalties. If I write a song with you, Sean goes on as a songwriter. So when we, both you and me, collect royalties for that song, I get the cut, Sean gets the cut, and you, your legal name, gets the royalties. Not whatever artist name you're using, and not Tie-Dye Kitty. So a lot of you have been using your artist name as the songwriter, and your songs are getting rejected. That's the reason. When you write a song, or when a songwriter writes a song, he gets 6 copyrights. Right to reproduce, right to distribute your work, distribute your work, the right to create derivative works, the right to publicly perform your music or the song, the right to publicly display, and the right to publicly perform, as in song recordings. If you are going to be a record label, for instance, if you have a record label, or if you are doing a cover song, there are a few other instances. But generally what happens is that if you are doing something like that, you need to get authorization from the actual songwriter. You did not write the song, but you want to distribute the song under your record label or whatever other entity you have formed to release music, or haven't really thought about what exactly you might be doing. But you need to get permission to distribute somebody else's work. They need to give you permission. So they need to write a letter that will include their name, a photocopy of the national ID card or a photo of it, any song registrations that they have for the song, copyright registration for the song, or let's say a PRO registration for the song, Public Performance Rights Organization. We can backcheck their signature on the document and to the identification card. So once you could verify the signatures on the letter to the ID card or the passport by your music distributor, you will then have your distribution authorization once that is signed over to you. If you're a songwriter, which I'm sure you are, you need to register with the Creative Passport. It's going to be your professional digital portfolio. It's coming on stream very, very soon. So I'm going to leave a link for the Creative Passport in the description now. Go register right now. If this video is helpful, please give it a thumbs up. Boom. Buy me a cup of coffee. Come see me soon. Peace.